杨文。
The corner there. Not a lot of space to sneak through, but Chun Xingtong makes it fit. Just on the chase, Wang Yidi not able to keep up with the pace. Little strawberry action quickly on the receive. That side top spin from the backhand of Chun Xingtong. But it doesn't bother Wang Yidi, and they quickly get into the rally.
Run three.
Steady and stable with 75% of the points at the table. Wang Yidi keeping the hand cool. In a good position so far. Tied right back up. Two quick ones for Chun Xingtong coming into the first towel break. There will be no coaches on benches here, as both players represent Team China. They're going to be on their own with the years of experience and wisdom that has been poured into them, the sacrifices they've made, and all the work they've put in to be here now.
Red, 3-0.
This rhythm, Chun Xingtong gets into it, and Wang Yidi finishes it. Both players looking quite comfortable after about the fourth shot in this rally.
Red, 4-3.
I'll be curious to see how the receive game changes from Tong Tong, Chun Xingtong. Little bits of side spin bother some people, but Wang Yidi has been in control, taking both of the last 2 points on serve. Extended rally, and it's Tong Tong who takes it. The crowd here appreciates a good point. You might think the fans here are all Japanese, but I'll tell you, a high percentage are actually Chinese fans. Where table tennis goes, so does Team China. Qin Zhijian, Ma Lin, and the rest of the gang here.
Five, oh.
Not so common we see an outright service point at this level. Not just this level, but teammates. And a big reason for that is there's less trickery in the sense they both know each other's games so well that they're rarely getting short points.
Five, six.
But another relatively short point. It's Chun Xingtong who plays patiently here. Wang Yidi, that shot's very effective when it's over the table, but from a step behind, tougher to get the surprising wide angle.
Red, 5-6.
The step around forehand sets up 2 point advantage now. Chun Xingtong was trailing. Nice side, a little bit of topspin. Beautiful shot to the line. To the wine. That's line and wide at the same time. Is fine like wine. Oh, right back to where it came from, a step around, and as soon as she comes back to center herself, the ball's behind the body's momentum. Wang Yidi with a very safe yet clever pattern. Watch it right back to this backhand corner. When the ball comes in wide, it's easier to send back wider. This rally is too good.
Oh.
I'm watching Chunxing Tong recover, maybe because she's on the left of the screen and I read left to right, but she's recovered so many difficult shots, and then for the last three or four, she's turned back up the pace. Looks to be in control. There she was pinned. As soon as she got hit in the elbow, had to turn and play the middle, Wang Yidi knew she could follow up aggressively and move into the net. Oh, defense for only so long. Relentless, merciless attacks. Wang Yidi, a machine, a factory, just producing incredible balls one after another. The spin there, the misdirection, that's the creativity. I only use machine in the sense that she keeps producing these incredible shots. Otherwise, you'll almost never hear me say that. But Wang Yidi, looking incredible right now.
Eight,
oh. Oh, timing. Irony. Where's that one in the dictionary? Let's see. Hey, just last 2 points there. A little bit of squirming in the seats, a little bit of jacket pocket time there for Qin Zhijian and Ma Lin. Looking for some lint or something to put in the fingertips in a moment like this. 8 points apiece here, nothing between the two.
Nine, eight.
Impressive defense that the third ball didn't win the point outright. Wang Yidi able to hang in for a bit, but the serve really set up Tong Tong with a powerful position, some good leverage in this rally. Heavy spin right back, and they'll go into the third towel break, tied up at 9 points apiece. Chunxing Tong saying, here's what she did, here's what I need to do. She swings up like that, there's going to be a lot of topspin on it. It's tough to describe to you. If you have a chance, you have a friend who plays tournaments, and you like ping pong, but you've never actually been to a tournament, ask him, say, give me your spinniest serve. Give me a spinny shot, just try it. Then say, how do you do that? And what do I do to get it back on the table next time or within a few feet of the table? 9 points apiece. Chunxing Tong with the toes on the line. It's a best of seven here, a long way to go. This game isn't over either as the players dry their hands on the table. Constant hopping around. Chunxing Tong pinning that middle. Lightning speed and a clinched fist. Wang Yidi ties it up, saves a game point. They will alternate serves until one player has a 2-point lead. Toes, just on the toes. The heels tap and ground from time to time. The physical conditioning for both of these players is almost unrivaled, only from those wearing the same flag and at the top of the game. Deuce.
Five.
Tries to break it out to the forehand. Test Wang Yidi, and Wang Yidi passes the test with flying colors. Game point to Wang Yidi this time around. She's got the serve to convert it. Clever idea, but the change of pace doesn't bother Wang Yidi. She moves in on top. Right back down the line, quick. Easier said than done, but Chun Xing Tong, if she can take the ball a little bit earlier, it's gonna have a little bit more of an impact on Wang Yidi. Wang Yidi hadn't even come down. She was just getting back into position when that ball was contacted.
Run,
oh. A little fortune there, Wang Yidi acknowledging it quickly. But level once again after 2 points have been played. Run. Oh, surprise long serve got her behind the table, but the net, Wang Yidi. It's always tough, especially when you're right on top of the table, because there's less time to adjust. The ball just changed its pace off the net. Oh, it's reflective edge tape with her name. Oh, it was just the lighting. It's yellow. Okay. Aya! Omiyage, a souvenir to take back from Japan. Chun Xing Tong giving a gift. So a lot of momentum here right now. Wang Yidi, 6 of the last 8 points.
3-2.
You might recall her saving a game point from down 9-10. Continuing here, last time they played, Wang Yidi won 4-1. But the time before that, Chun Xing Tong won 3-0. So many IOUs right now. She's almost embarrassed, doesn't even look her opponent in the eye, just raises her hand and is like, yeah, well, it happens. I can't worry about it. Neither should you, but it's going to help my score line out right now. So they're 1-1 in their last 2 encounters. But Wang Yidi won the 4 before that, between the years 2015 and 2022.
Five.
So what's it going to take for Chun Xing Tong at this point? How can she surprise Wang Yidi? This is where knowledge of patterns, you have to know patterns so deeply, and these players do. That's why they come up with new patterns in real time.
Six.
Tried to change it up. She moves over to the forehand side of the table for the pendulum serve. Sometimes you'll see that just to mix it up. Good touch right there. Wang Yidi not phased at all. This is her bread and butter, the backhand over the table.
Breakfast.
Breakfast?
Stop.
Well, maybe she said play fast. Also
six,
sounds delicious.
Two.
Yellow card for Chun Xing Tong for taking time for breakfast on the table.
Seven.
Now, what does a yellow card mean? A yellow card means warning, and if I give you another yellow card, it's a yellow presented with a red, which means 1 point to your opponent. That could determine the game or the match.
Two, eight.
It is a runaway train right now, Wang Yidi. We've seen some big comebacks before. 12 of the last 16 keeps chugging away. Oh, man. Toot, toot, all aboard the Wang Yidi train.
Nine, three.
I know we talked earlier about spin and how much of a factor it is, but even just hearing that ball and then seeing it crawl back into the net, you can make the ball do crazy things in table tennis. Jump, kick, and dive. That man's done it all. Both of those men, actually, but Qin Zhijian, not quite as recently as Ma Lin.
9-4.
Best rally in a long time. It's been a while since we've seen Chunxing Tong really able to get herself into the rallies here. A lot of backhand to backhand rallies you're going to see in the women's game typically. The faster shot to recover from. 4 game points for Wang Yidi.
5-10.
Now down to 5 as Chunxing Tong spins with the forehand. Cleans the rubber, then dries the hand. 5 serving 10.
11,
well,
five,
quite a one-sided performance after saving a game point in game number 1. To make sure she's got consistent spin and traction. The free hand. Now, you can hit the ball with your hand as long as the hand is holding the racket. So if that ball comes down, it doesn't matter because the left hand had no racket. Point already over as soon as she touched it with the left hand. Chunxing Tong looking to get that forehand into play. Turning the corner quickly, taking some chances. After last game, I think that's, well, definitely called for at this point.
3.
There it is, shorter rallies. Not a flinch from the VIP section. Strawberry side spin. Then the quick down the line shot. So Tong Tong with 6 of the last 8 points. I love it, the spring in her step. It's so cool, the preparation for that forehand. I think anyone who plays a sport really appreciates how cool the pros look when their technique is just so fast and fluid.
5
points in a row, even the little things. I can't see the live stream right now, but I want to say, Hart, if you agree, even the sound of the stomp is so cool to me when they stomp on the serve.
Love, 6.
First towel break, and Wang Yidi is going to need a little bit more towel. In terms of pressure right now, that's half long, right back by that double fish sign, Shuang Yu. Double fish.
Love, 7.
I was thinking back, we had a lot of conversations, the staff and I, about mercy points. If someone's up 10-0, still a long way to go, medium long way to go. Chunxing Tong stands still, holds her ground, gets everything back. Hungry for a point right now, looking for anything between the teeth she can find. Wang Yidi. Real time. Slapped back, the backhand punch, taking her chances. Ah, there it is. Okay, okay, says Chunxing Tong. You can take that one, but just that one. Backspin over the table, and instead of the flick, she goes passive. Not an easy ball to play, but Wang Yidi can do that all day.
1-9.
1-9. Chunxing Tong, after being beaten 11-5, looking to make quite a statement here. 12 of the last 16 points for Tong Tong.
2-9.
But she has to keep her focus. That was for me. If I was her coach, that's a sign. She played a push from behind the table. That's incredibly uncommon to do.
9-3.
Even 1 point. Whenever the ball comes long in table tennis, typically, unless you're a defender, and even then sometimes you'll see players taking the attack, you take the attack. You take control of the point. So two in a row now for Wang Yidi. I think it was yesterday we saw Chunxing Tong call a timeout quite conservatively. Nice angle here, and it sets up 7 game points. Still a long way to go in this match. Yeah, I think she was up 10-4, maybe 10-3, and then 1 point was made against her. She called the timeout, but no timeout needed here. 11-3, a dominant game, quite a response. And by this game, I mean the rest of this match. Wang Yidi 2-1 leading.
One, down.
That's okay for me. Just like Chunxing Tong, I'm shaking my head saying yes. Stick with the plan. It worked last game, 11 of 14 points played.
Left, one, long.
Ooh, little help off the net on the way over, but even still, we normally see Wang Yidi adjust quite quickly. Side top, just missing the contact, Wang Yidi. Heavy spin on this one, Wang Yidi gets low and powers up with the legs, really springs up. That pivot turns the whole body just to shift around to make room for that backswing on the forehand. And a 1 point lead for Wang Yidi. Oh, it's too good. I watched this point thinking Wang Yidi's got it. She's figured it out. She's gonna play as aggressively as possible, pin it into the elbow and then the deep backhand back and forth to keep Chunxing Tong guessing. And Chunxing Tong with the racket high escapes with a counter punch. Nice parallel forehand. That was big after Chunxing Tong retrieved that wide forehand, still managed to regain her balance. See the moment here? That was not an easy ball, but it was like nothing happened. She was right back and ready in play. But still coming down as Wang Yidi contacted the ball.
Two, four.
Strawberry does not scale the net. So with the first towel break, it turns out that if Chunxing Tong wins the semifinals, she moves ahead of Hina Hayata to the number 5 spot. This is her maximum. Even if she becomes the champion, Chunxing Tong, number 5 would be her best result in the world rankings.
3-4.
Wang Yidi, on the other hand, can become number 2 or number 3 if she wins the semifinals. But she needs to at least win the semifinal to outperform Chun Meng's result to become number 2. Oh, on the run, the move. This ball out of reach with the head down to have the wherewithal to play this off the side of the table. Yeah, tongue out moments indeed. Wide from the backhand, parallel, right on the line, full stretch, and turns it back. The athleticism in this shot. All that preparation for moments like this.
Three.
So Sunying Xia will remain number 1 in the world for some time. No one in this event can take her over as number 1. She's the defending back-to-back champion of this event. Looking for a three-peat, but right now these two looking for a spot in that final. Sunying Xia will have to get through Chun Meng, who beat her at the Olympic Games just about 2.5 years ago. And Wang Manyu needs both Wang Yidi and Chun Meng to lose in the semifinals if she is going to remain number 2 in the world.
4-7.
Clever idea, but it doesn't work out for Tong Tong. It's Wang Yidi on top of everything for the change of pace. Spin shot shallow, plays it out forward. People often ask, do you change grip between forehand and backhand? And people think, no, of course not. The ball moves so fast. Speaking of fast, six of the last eight to Wang Yidi. Quick turn there. Taking control of this game, no doubt about it.
Nine.
But the answer is they do change grips. It just happens incredibly fast. When you play the backhand, the thumb comes up a little bit more, so you get finger pressure to add behind the racket when you're hitting the ball. The pointer finger on the forehand is what's adding more pressure. Oh, tough way to win a point, but she'll take it. Chunxing Tong spins it to the middle. A little bit of bait there, a dangling carrot on a string. As Wang Yidi turns to play. Oh, I like carrots. Man, give me one. Perfect lip read. Five serving nine. And inside out, the deep corner here. Chunxing Tong steps around. Remember, both players have their timeouts, except they tend to come a little bit later when there are no coaches on the benches.
Nine,
this is crazy.
Seven.
Timeout here, Wang Yidi. Nine serving seven.
Nine, eight.
But the streak continues. Chunxing Tong. It looked like she was going down 1-3. Most of this game, that was the writing on the wall, or at least the scoreboard. No final stamp has been put on it. How can you play table tennis any better? Tested everywhere on the table. Wang Yidi and Chunxing Tong putting on a show. The clinging and clashing of the swords out here. This fight is epic. Medieval times with the most modern, fast, and strong in the game. And it's Wang Yidi to set up two game points for that 3-1 lead. But it's not over yet. Back against the ropes. But the serve for a little consolation. And it will not pass. I'm sure you watching at home have DJ'd your fair share of women's semifinals. Right down the line, Wang Yidi with the quick decision. Change up there. A whole lot of gambare in the crowd. From our Japanese-speaking fans. There it is. This is the Chunxing Tong that we saw in game number three in the second half of game number four. But really game number three. If you remember how it started, there was a lot of stepping around. There were a lot of short rallies. Tong Tong trying to stamp her impression strongly early on. Little break off the net here, but the body language, you see the turn. Tong Tong looking to get that forehand into play. Tong Tong has a very quick transition to the forehand from the body, from the elbow, turning around the backhand corner. Now this is when she becomes dangerous, when Wang Yidi can't say, stay in the backhand corner and cause me no harm. Wang Yidi did play that deep to the backhand, as if to say, I don't want to deal with your forehand. Chunxing Tong said, yeah, that's cool. Try this instead. Fast, long serve right to the baseline. Remember, Chunxing Tong has a yellow card, but she still has her timeout. Wang Yidi, well, does not.
2-4.
But you still got a whole lot of game. Wang Yidi with the heavy spin. Chunxing Tong closing the racket. just to keep that spin down, to keep the ball from flying off the back of the table, which she does, but it catches the net and goes out. I love these points. I shake my head up here with disbelief, watching the screen, thinking how fast these balls go back and forth and how many different ways there are to win a point out here. Doesn't miss by much. Good spin right to the baseline. Chun-Sing Tong keeping the pressure on. Rocket backhand. Took a while to get there. This point had about four forehands in a row in the middle. Remember, in the women's game, you don't see forehand to forehand rallies quite as much. One cover leans way off onto the left foot. And that lean, that placement, courtesy of Wang Yidi, sets her up with a nice follow-up attack. An opponent leaning just one way. Five serving three, Chun-Sing Tong. Oh, edge of the racket, edge of the table. You've got double happiness for if it hits the net in the edge. Ooh, net returned and it comes back. A 2-point lead once again for Chun-Sing Tong. Has the timeout paid off? Well, so far, it's a step in the right direction, but it will only have paid off if Chun-Sing Tong wins this game, and in theory, the match.
Five, six.
Wang Yidi not letting it get too far out of hand. Finger on the ball, thumb up on the back of the racket for that punch. Oh, the step around. This is what she wants. It's the quality of shot. Wang Yidi says, yes, I know you want to do this, but you're going to have to do it from right at the baseline. Interesting. The bounce actually a bit more shallow in that replay, so change of pace causing the trouble. Could say that, or you could say that Chun-Sing Tong simply surprised not making a shot that she would normally make.
7-6.
Clever idea from Wang Yidi to go back down the line. It's nice getting these different camera angles in the replays. It gives you different perspective. Sometimes it all happens so fast, it's tough to really appreciate exactly what's happening. Rocket backhand off the bounce, using the length of the table for a bit of security surrounding the speed. This is why parallel shots are so important. They surprise people, because the length of the table, the diagonal, is the much higher percentage shot, the safer way to go. More room for error.
6.
Pattern recognized. Chun-Sing Tong right there for the parallel forehand of Wang Yidi. And Wang Yidi says, nah, I got to find something new. Got to surprise her. Good closure there with the racket. Could also be a head shake of simply the last shot.
9-7.
In the replay, again, that camera angle showing Wang Yidi from the middle. As well practiced as both of these players are, they are human after all. Incredibly consistent, but not perfect.
9.
Soft
eight.
Touch of the short forehand. No timeouts left. Just a little breath there to keep the hand cool. Tong Tong still up by one, looking to extend this match. What placement, what feeling from Wang Yidi. Change up to the backhand side of the racket on the serve. Interesting. Interesting. Wang Yidi shares the feelings out here. Not the type of interesting she would like, but as a spectator, It's always fun to see something mixed up a bit. When your heart's fully behind one player, though, depends who it is. It's two game points now for Chun Xing Tong. Beautiful change of direction, leaving skid marks on the other side. We know what Chun Meng would do in a moment like this. Wang Yidi. This is a replay, by the way. As fast as can be, stretching, testing the groin on the other side. One game point left. No, my goodness. Ma'am, did you realize how fast you were going? This is above the limit here. Wang Yidi just passing on through. Setting off some sirens on this one. The forehand deep to the corner. Chun Xing Tong, nothing to be done. If you don't see her lunge or reach, it's back to the backhand. Worked out last time around. Top and side spin received well, and it is game and match point for Wang Yidi. This could be a relatively quick one, considering 12-10 in game one, and deuce here, but now match point to Wang Yidi. And Wang Yidi takes it, 4-1. Chun Xing Tong has been knocked out in the semifinals. So we have our first finalist, Wang Yidi.